the third kind of sex, it changes a little bit. Sex ain't quite as good. You know, sometimes it's fun, sometimes it's loud, sometimes it's quiet, but it's called hall sex. That's when you pass each other in the hall, fuck you. That's the stage that I'm in right now. And if it keeps going too long, it ends up as a threesome. It's called courtroom sex. It's where you get to sit in a room and her and the lawyer get to fuck you while the judge watches. That's the last fucking straw. Don't be confused with a threesome. That is what she's talking about. There is no fucking chance in a free ride there, lady. I mean, you're gonna lose it all. Alright, so you know what women and tornadoes have in common?
What?
They both moan like hell when they come and take the fucking house when they leave.
Damn right. Damn right.
I mean, fuck. That's why I'm still married. You know what the difference is between a pregnant woman and a light bulb?
What?
You can unscrew a light bulb. So my wife tells me the other day, she says I need to go to the doctor. Seems that right when I'm climaxing, I scream real fucking loud. I don't know, we go to the doctor, I don't see a problem with it, doctor don't see a problem with it. I mean, she's the only one that has a problem with it. I guess it's because it wakes her up. But I had a friend explain the difference in oral sex and anal sex. I didn't ask. He was just like, hey, you know what the difference is between oral sex and anal sex? Yeah? Well, let me tell you. Oral sex, good oral sex will make your day. It'll make your fucking day. It'll make you great. Now, anal sex will make your whole week.
Yeah.
Now, I don't know where you're going with that. I'm scared to try. Anyway, before I got married, I was always frank with the ladies I had sex with. And mainly because I didn't want them knowing my real name. But I guess I look like a frank, so they went for it. Now, here's something I found out recently. Push-up bras and Doritos have a lot in common. Okay. And you have to fight like hell to get them open, and then when you do, they're only fucking half full.
Damn right.
I mean, seriously, what are they doing with all that extra fucking space? I mean, if you're going to give me little bitty bag of chips, why are you in such a big ass pack? I mean, that's...
Anyway,
they're expensive.
Like, that's me.
Alright, so I'm a manager at a local print shop here in town. My wife works with me.
No false expectations.
She's been real depressed lately, man. She ain't talking to nobody. You know, just walking around, drinking and shit. And we get home the other day, and I'm trying to talk to her, make her feel good. She likes when you appreciate, you know, her hard work. I mean, so... I gave her some laundry to do and asked her to make me a sandwich. I mean, what the fuck, man? You know? I thought that was good. Anyway, we've been doing a little remodeling around the house. We got an old basement. We're trying to clean it up. My son's going to move down there. I got a dehumidifier. Y'all ever got one of these things? You know, when I was a kid, we had a humidifier. It just pumped vapors in the air. You get to watch the little vapors. Dehumidifier takes the water out of the air. So I've got this thing hooked up. There's fucking water just pouring out of this hose. I'm like, where is all this water coming from? It's like all this water is in the air. This thing pumps 70 pints of water a day out of the air. Now, that's a lot of fucking water. So we decided we're just going to seal up the basement. We're going to have a redneck swimming pool.
There you go.
So I'm filling that son of a bitch up. Here in about 6 years, we'll be fucking swimming, y'all. Everybody can come. It's a big ass room. Awesome. So, is there any hard working ladies in here tonight?
Yeah.
Work your ass off to the fucking bone.
Yes, sir.
And supervisors, managers.
Fuck them.
Any of that kind of shit. I give you props. I mean, that's.